Hello and welcome back. So we're going to be adding curves to the horizontal alignment that we just did in the last video. So the first thing we're going to do is you're going to go up here to Geometry, Arcs, Arc Between Elements, and then Simple Arc. Once you do that, you're going to click on your first tangent and your second tangent. You're going to notice that as you're pulling it away, it goes to either side, so you need to have it select it to roughly the right side. Go ahead and type in 3,000. So it's a 3,000 foot radius to that curve. Hit tab. And if you move your mouse, you'll notice that it sinks in and goes into the correct placement. You'll also notice out here it says the radius is equal to 3,000 square or single foot or survey foot. Sorry. So once you do that, go ahead and click again. It's gonna appear right there, and then it's gonna give you the trim option. So for this, we definitely wanna go ahead and just trim and extend both. Once you do that, it's gonna trim it up, and you're gonna have a nice curve there. Now all you're gonna do for the rest of this is just repeat it. The only difference is this curve and this curve are all gonna be 12,900 radius instead. So go ahead and do that, and you'll catch up with me here in a bit. Okay, so you're not really going to notice much of a difference on these. The big thing you'll notice is that when you hover over it, there's a slight curve in there. So you've got your length, then you've got your curve, you got your line, and then you've got... Well, actually, that might just go straight into a continuous curve. Actually, it's probably just got a tiny line in here somewhere. Nope. So it's a continuous curve at this point, but you've got your other line right here. What we're going to do now is we're going to go ahead and create a complex alignment. And so to do that, all you have to do is go to complex geometry right here. You can either drop it down, and you can either, and we're going to do complex by element because we've already created the elements. Thing you want to do first is set this to automatic, and you can leave the gap as is. It's not going to matter with it being set to automatic. And then to start this off, you're going to select the first tangent in the alignment, so this one up here. The big thing to make sure is that the arrow is going this way, so going down, so going from here to here, and that's how the arrow is pointed. To do that, you'll have to click close to the top of the tangent, or the beginning of the tangent. If you click towards the end, it's going to point it in the opposite direction. So just remember that, opposite of where you want the arrow to go, that's where you're clicking. So you'll click, I'll ask you to accept the complex. It's hard to tell if it's highlighted or not because of how I've got my viewing property set up, but it should be highlighted. And then left click again to accept the complex. If you hover over it, you'll notice that mine brightened up quite a bit. That's how I know that the entire complex got selected. And it's all one piece, is that the entire thing is just completely selected. You'll also notice that when I go to my properties window and click on it, it's got a feature name. So I want you to go ahead and change that to 23141-05-CRL. So right over here. Just make sure that the feature definition is set to proposed. Once you've got this changed, go ahead and click enter. If you come here, click down, you go to your alignments, you go to proposed. You're now going to notice you have a complex element named 23141-05-CRL. Once you've done that, you've created your complex element or your alignment, and you are done with this. So we'll see you in the next video.